World Sports Betting presents Tom Theocharis versus Petey Coxton.
And this is an absolute fascinating middleweight matchup between the veteran Petey Coxton and the Canadian Tom Theocharis. And what can you say about Petey Coxton fighting out of Junkyard MMA? I mean, this guy has been there, done it. Absolutely fantastic record. So many fights, so many wars. You can talk about his record and a couple of those losing streaks, even though he's coming off that fantastic win over Wade Henson in his last fight. I mean, Petey just wants one of those guys who, his phone rings, EFC call him, he'll be here within the minute to stand and bang and put on a fight for the fans. That's the kind of fighter everyone likes to see as he steps into the Rhino Beer prep zone, extra bold, premium strength. That's the kind of Petey Coxton is. That's the kind of fighter, just a very bold guy who'll answer the call and just stand in the middle and put on a show for the fans.
Not afraid of a fight, that's for sure. Petey Coxton is the guy who says, I'm available at any time. One day, 2 day, 10 day, full camp, Petey Coxton will come to bang. I'd like to see how he's progressed. We've seen progression in him over the last couple of fights. Forever improving, forever putting the effort in to be more. He wants to welcome the Canadian in the best way possible. You see him with South African trunks. You'll be proud to wear those. You know you'll come with the heart of a lion. He won't give up till the end. Can he be the test for the Canadian, Tom? First time to the shores of South Africa, home of the EFC, where many, many, many foreigners have come. Some have had great success and some have failed to get their name up in lights. The Canadian, Tom, Canada got such a rich MMA culture. I spent a lot of time there, trained with some of the best guys in the world, Rory McDonald, George St. Pierre. Man, they love the sport. They're so good at it and they're such good technicians when it comes to the game. I want to see, does he possess the same abilities as what I've seen over there in the Rhino prep point, getting the check there, been there many times, Simon, love that. It's that moment when you're ready and fired up.
Well, this is your division, Gareth, and he's a natural middleweight. You could see Chris Horodetsky, a Canadian MMA legend, in his corner there. But Tom Theocharis was a training partner for many UFC fighters, Sam Stout, Mark Hominick, Horodetsky himself. And he was a sparring partner for many years with the kind of caliber of fighters that we sometimes see coming from the States. Also Alaskan state champion, similar to our former champ, Dave Mazzani, now based in Las Vegas, where Tom Theocharis has also been doing a fair bit of training. And this fight was made about a year ago, Gareth, but it was actually derailed by a personal tragedy for Tom Theocharis. So it's great to finally have him back here and face Petey Coxton, which is what we wanted about a year ago. And it's a fight so long in the making, and it is a fight brought to you by World Sports Betting. Bet with the best. And with that, let's take a look at the World Sports Betting Teller Tape. 11 years older is Petey Coxton, 2 inches higher is the Canadian Theocharis, and it's just a 1-inch reach advantage or thereabouts that goes to the South African Petey Coxton. So without further ado, let's get this prelim featured bout underway with the voice of the hexagon, Kotso Bilal Ramopo.
Ladies and gentlemen, this bout is scheduled for 3 rounds in the EFC middleweight division. Introducing first, in the red corner, a boxer with 7 wins and 13 losses. He stands at 6 feet, weighing in at 182 pounds, fighting out of Johannesburg, South Africa. Oh, welcome, Petey Thunder Coxton! And his opponent in the blue corner, a kickboxer with 5 wins and 4 losses. He stands at 6'2", weighing in at 183 pounds. the fighting pride of Stratford, Canada, I give to you, Tom, the Greek warrior, Theocharis! Your referee for this bout, referee Bobby Karagiannidis.
Bobby Karagiannidis overlooking this middleweight scrap at EFC 97. It is our featured prelim bout here at the Performance Institute. A lovely angel joining us for this first round. Very many first round finishes here at EFC 97. Will this one be the first to go to the distance? Something tells me no. It's Coxon in the black and South African flag swatch. And the Canadian Theocharis in the white, the black and the white shorts.
Tom the Greek. What an interesting name. You look at the list of guys that he's trained with. Unbelievable UFC veterans. Stout Hominick. Man, was an absolute animal on the feet. Chad Lepree, somebody I know exceptionally well. Spent a lot of time with him. He looks comfortable. Good range. Peter Coxon, though, says hi.
Look out for that big overhand right from Coxon, but it's Theocharis starting out with a kicking attack straight away. My kind of instinct was that Theocharis would try and take Coxon down and test him on the ground and use his striking to set up the takedown, but it's actually Peter Coxon who has the single. Nice knee from Theocharis.
Trying to turn the corner there. Petey doing exceptionally well onto the back. Good job, Peter Coxon. Double under hooks.
Oh, big knee. Big right by Theocharis. Coxon's covering up. Theocharis is pouring it on. He's trying to finish. Big knee again from Theocharis. And Coxon is out. And then the flag's up. Good stoppage by Bobby Karagiannidis.
Just the floodgates open.
Great knockout for Tom Theocharis in his first fight in the EFC. Great to see Coxon straight back up. Great show of respect between both these two lads. Beautiful stand-up work from Tom Theocharis. We waited a year for that and we are not disappointed. Canada, you have a real fantastic new name in global mixed martial arts and the Greek warrior, Tom Theocharis. What a great display of striking. Really mix it up. The knees started really coming home, up the middle, into the chest, up high. Started laying down a standing ground to pound on Coxon. I think it was a left hook that finally put him down. Talk us through a Sonic Action Replay, Gareth, because that was a cracker.
Well, it's good on the feet in the beginning with the range. Good kicks. Showed intention behind that. Closed the space quickly. There was an exchange. Petey got on the back. Did exceptionally well to escape. Big knee. And they just poured it on with the hooks. Just a barrage of punches in that clinch. Petey didn't have time to think. Big knee again. Those knees were very effective. Little bit wild at stages there in the clinch. But that excitement and that drive to finish and that desire to be aggressive, such a great thing to see. Many of the Canadian guys I've come across, once they smell blood, they are vicious in their ability to complete and win.
It was good movement from Petey with his back against the hex. He was really trying to bob and weave, but there really was no escape from that kind of barrage from Tom Theocharis. Even in the Sonic Action Replay, it was so fast. It was laying it on with beautiful hand speed, beautifully placed knees, and it was a good stoppage by Bobby Karagiannidis. Great to see Peter Coxon. He'll live to fight another day, that's for sure. Always a tough customer. A great display by Theocharis and a good display of sportsmanship. So let's get the official result in the book and send it up to the voice of the hex, Kotso Bilal Ramopo.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Bobby Karagiannidis has called a stop to this contest at 59 seconds of the very first round, declaring your winner by TKO due to strikes, Tom, the Greek warrior, Theocharis.
As we've seen all fight week, a great show of respect between both martial artists. Tom Theocharis, what a way of announcing yourself to the EFC. Just tell us who that win was for and tonight why.
That win's obviously for my girlfriend, friends, family. What's up, Johannesburg? Thank you guys so much for having me. Graham, Tao, Simon, everyone. Thank you guys so much. Chris Hordecki, everyone.
Legend of Canadian MMA, Chris Horodetsky in the corner. Just what's next for you? We waited a year for you to come and fight, and we hope that you're going to come back real soon. What's the discussion we're going to be with the UFC? Obviously, we've loved having you, and we can't wait for you to come back real soon. What's the plan?
Let's get that fucking title. 185, 170, let's do it.
And just talk us through the UFC experience with you and Chris. What's it been like here this week? What do you have to say to Canada about what the UFC is about?
UFC is an incredible organization. Everyone from top to bottom, the Capitol Hotel, everyone was so nice. Made me feel like home, and thank you, everyone.
Were you surprised that he was able to cope with the stand-up? Because you laid it on really thick. I was going to expect you to take it down and test him on the ground game. Was the plan to keep it standing the whole time?
My plan was to beat him up, so we did that.
That you did. Can't wait to see you back. Your winner, ladies and gentlemen, the Greek warrior, Tom Theocharis.
Difficult place to come and win. The African shores are not very friendly. Some monsters who lurk the waters here. But he came out, he stamped his authority early. He took away the veteran, put his hand up and said, hey guys, take a look at me. I'm from Canada, I'm determined. I want the best of what you got in Africa. Good outing, young man. We look forward to seeing you again.